I asked myself, how much did this title change my life? I have to say that even though it did not bring me any spectacular immediate success, I have gained a lot. I never wanted to be any kind of stage person, but being a participant of Miss World and Miss Caribbean Hibiscus taught me how to represent my country with grace, how to show the best side of my personality, and finally, how to be myself facing large audiences. I have become much more open, outgoing, and self-confident. Miss World was for me a wonderful experience. The most important thing for me was that I could meet so many great people, founders, sponsors, and 89 beautiful girls from all over the world. They were kind and friendly. We definitely enjoyed our time together in India and Seychelles. On the 14th of December 1996, I won Miss Caribbean Hibiscus in the beautiful island of St. Martin, an experience I will never forget for as long as I live. To this year's contestant, I would like to say that winning isn't everything. Remember, you're a winner in your own way. You have achieved a lot by just participating. Believe me when I say it takes a lot to do what you're doing tonight. Good luck to all. In closing, I would like to thank God Almighty, my parents and family, Well Services Marine Limited, MK Enterprises, and all the important people who have made my reign a truly beautiful one. I will be eternally grateful to you all.
God has really blessed me. He made me a dreamer, one that knows that anything is possible with prayer and a bit of hard work. For me, it seems as if my destiny draws me. I know what I must do and I go for it with everything I have in me, guided by our constant communication. Becoming Miss Trinidad and Tobago for Miss Universe is what I've wanted all my life. I felt as if I was mesmerized on stage, and I could never forget the loud tears of encouragement that urged me, "You can do it, Margot," and part one of my dream was fulfilled. "Dare to dream, Margot," I would say to myself as the time drew near. I was coming closer to the second chapter of my fairy tale, the girl in the golden gown. Rehearsal seemed almost like a religious and ritualistic function, one that must be perfected, and we all had our part to play, to dance, to speak, to deave, to show the world who you are, Trinbagonian. What is it that you have that makes you so special? I showed them. As I pass on the crown of Miss Trinidad and Tobago, I wish my successor Godspeed and the very best. I now reign as the second runner-up to Miss Universe 1997 and will continue to travel the world doing my country proud as I fulfill other dreams. Thank you, the people of Trinidad and Tobago. It is because of you and others like you all over the world that I can now say the taste of victory is indeed sweet, although I did not win the crown. May God bless you all. Thank you. Kicked out the moss.
Very special thanks.
And our 1996 representatives taking their position on stage. We move on now to the representatives to present, well, there is the prize, Alison, the crown, etc., for Miss Caribbean Hibiscus,
Miss Universe,
and Miss World.
Right. Lovely.
And before we do that, we call on stage now the wife of the Honourable Minister of Housing and Settlements, Mrs. Helen Humphrey, to join us on stage. Would you please welcome, ladies and gentlemen, Mrs. Helen Humphrey.
I'd like you to bring the crown on stage, please, because I'll be calling the title and Wendell will be giving the name. first person to be crowned, first young lady to be crowned this evening, Miss Caribe Hibiscus.
And the title goes to Miss Sportsman Members Club, Nicole James.
We'd like to say a very special thanks to Mrs. Helen Humphrey for coming on stage and crowning our beautiful queen.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, will you please welcome on stage to crown the Miss Trinidad and Tobago representative to Miss World, the wife of the Honorable Prime Minister of Trinidad and Tobago, Mrs. Oma Pandey.
Miss Universe and Miss World to call on stage. We're going to call the young lady who will represent us in the Miss Universe beauty pageant.
All right. The representative for the Miss Universe beauty pageant for Trinidad and Tobago, Wendy Fitzwilliam, Miss Gulf City. Gentlemen, Wendy Fitzwilliam.
Mrs. Pandey to stay on stage, please, because we'd like to now announce the lady who will represent the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago in the Miss World Beauty Pageant.
Ladies and gentlemen, she is Mandy Jagdale, Miss Toyota. Thank you. presents to Miss Caribe Hibiscus, Miss Universe.